When I was a kid, my brother and I used to pretend we were heroes with swords. We were the only ones who could save the day. But perhaps we set the bar a little bit high. Maybe we're just regular people. The ones who get saved.
Idea.
Swear jar.
Fuck the swear jar.
Aidan.
I'm sorry, but fuck the swear jar.
That word means sex. You're gonna have sex with the swear jar?
Okay, Tucker, that's enough, honey. The code's 1234. What are you doing?
The swear jar is full. Look at it. The swear jar is all the money we have to send you to college, so you should be happy, I curse.
I heard you, Dad. Rabbi Perlman says that cursing is for the simple-minded.
Well, Rabbi Perlman's breath is so bad, it makes God question why he even bothered creating the universe. Rabbi Perlman's praying, and God's like, please stop, Perlman! You're welcome! You're welcome!
Well, if you can curse, then we all can curse. Is that what you want?
Fine.
No. Grace is not gonna curse.
Fuckhead!
Wow!
Gracie!
Whoa!
Mom, Dad said that the other day when someone stole his parking spot.
I did say that, babe, but he was a fuckhead, and he was in a yellow Hummer. Who drives a yellow Hummer? What is he, going to war on the sun?
Dad, we need this car.
We are not getting an Aston Martin. But for the next minute only, you can curse.
Then hairy balls.
Okay, come on, guys. Up, 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 up. Seat belts. Come on, what is wrong with you, man? Get it together.
I was thinking about that Aston Martin.
Stop thinking about that car. It's time to start thinking about the plight of the Jews.
What does plight mean?
I have no idea. Ask the rabbis. That's what we're paying them for.
You have to talk to your father today. He still hasn't paid this semester's tuition.
I hate talking about money. When was it due?
Months ago. Okay, and they're threatening to kick the kids out of school if they don't get a check by the end of this week. Maybe it's time we put them in public school.
No!
No, we're not putting them in public school. I'll talk to them today, okay?
Avoid the rabbis if you see them.
I always do.
Bye, Mom!
Bye, baby!
Up back there, Yentl?
Don't call me Yentl.
Don't call me Yentl. I love that movie.
I know.
The boys get to do all the cool things to honor Hashem, and I won't get to do anything remotely cool until I buy my shadel.
Shadel? What's that again?
It's a modesty wig. So when I get married, I'll shave my head and wear a wig for the rest of my life. That way only my husband will find me pretty.
No offense, but that is the weirdest tradition I've ever heard of. And it wouldn't even work on you because you're so pretty that you'd look even prettier with a shaved head. So it would defeat the whole purpose. Bye. Hurry.
Hey, guys.
Tucker, come here. Drill? I knew it. I told you, Drill stays at home. Thank you. Now go be Jewish.
Why? It's so boring.
I have no idea. Ask the rabbis.
Shalom.
Shalom.
I got it right here.
Oh, come on.
Sorry, just give me a second.
Shalom, Mr. Bloom.
Hey, Rabbi Rosenberg.
Mr. Bloom, Rabbi Tversky would like to see you in his office. If you have a moment.
Oh, you know, today I can't. Today, believe it or not, a moment is something I just don't have. I'm gonna have to take a rain check.
Speaking of rain, as you know, every year to celebrate the holiday of Tu Bishvat, we ask the children to donate money to have a tree planted in Israel.
Yeah, I heard about that, Rabbi, but when you think about it, how many trees do they really need over there? I feel like Israel's pretty good on trees.
Which is why, Mr. Bloom, we encourage the children to plant a seedling in their own backyard. You never picked up your seedling, Mr. Bloom.
Oh, no, I'm fine. Oh, there it is, okay. Thank you.
Just try not to smoke it.
Clever.
Baruch Hashem.
Yes, bless God. Bless her body.
I ask you, sir, three bangs, how many you bangs did Jesus
bang,
hear?
Bang, bang. This entire case is dependent on your testimony that on the night of January 7th, outside your neck, food, sir, you heard.
I ask you, sir, Jesus.
This shit is horrible. In college, I did Othello.
We all did.
Yep. Tell me about it.
Aidan, Paul, can I just speak to you both here for a quick second?
Yeah, sure. Hey, Terry.
Didn't your agents call you? We've decided to go African-American with the role.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me, man. I've been memorizing this all week.
Does he have to be a dark black person? What if he were light-skinned?
I'm sorry, guys.
Whoa, what about Ortega? Ortega, there's a guy on the witness stand, Ortega.
He's an older Hispanic man.
Hola, senor. I am on the witness stand and I only heard one bang. Uno bang. There was only one uno bang, not three, uno.
Aidan. Please tell me you're not trying to be an older Hispanic man.
I'm just trying to show you my range, man. I really, really need a part.
I'm sorry, guys.
If it's any consolation, I thought you were Hispanic.
Gracias.
De nada.
Catch you at a bad time.
Dad! What the hell?
Trouble in the bedroom, Aidan. Men have man needs. Those man needs need to be met.
Well, Sarah doesn't really care about my man needs right now, Dad. We have a lot going on.
So you're taking things into your own hands, so to speak.
Hilarious. Why haven't you paid the yeshiva tuition, Dad? I have aggro rabbis stalking me in crosswalks. It's like an Orthodox zombie movie.
We need to talk. But can you please clean yourself up first? I can't talk to you with your pants at your ankles.
Fine.
Kugel, no! Kugel! Sorry. I know you can't stand the dog. He's usually so well trained.
If you train that dog to piss everywhere but the lawn, then you did an incredible job.
Pool looks good. What are you growing, typhoid or hepatitis? What's going on with the fence? Got a nice little slice of Mumbai back here, Aidan.
The yard has been this way since we moved in. Are you going to comment on it every time you see it? I haven't gotten a decent check since I did that dandruff commercial.
And ironically, you still have dandruff.